Hey, everybody, and welcome to the online Fifth Avenue Church worship service. Us three are so excited to be here and worship with you all today. So let's just get straight into it.
Amazing grace. This is amazing.
Jesus, you do so many things for us, not just for me, and not just for these people in this room, not just for these people watching this service, but you do all things for the good of your children, Jesus. Thank you that you are good, and thank you that your grace is even beyond amazing. It is a grace that has freed us from our debts, freed us from our shame, freed us from our fears. So Jesus, I just pray that as we continue worship, more of your character will be revealed, whether through lyrics, whether through just the music speaking to us, whether it be through your spirit, or whether it be through like just something being revealed, Jesus. I pray more of your character and more of who you are will be revealed. And we'll just be so motivated to worship you, Jesus. We'll just realize you're so good, and that we just can't help but move our bodies and use our voices to sing, use our hands to do good works, all in your worship, Jesus, because that is what you're for. You're for the good of all people. Thank you, Jesus. I am Jesus, I pray that that'll be something that is reminded in our heads and in our hearts. They won't be disconnected, that it'll be something we both know through our mind and like know and believe in our hearts. That you are worth exalting, and that it'll be just something that we know, that it is better for us to exalt you rather than ourselves. When we exalt ourselves, Jesus, things don't work out so well. And just everything that is happening in the world currently is evidence of that. When we seek power, over others, Jesus, it doesn't end up so good. So Jesus, I just pray that we will be exalting you, something that is beyond us, someone who is beyond us, who has the ability to hold that power, but also humble themselves so greatly. Someone who is able to lead with compassion, someone who is able to rule with justice, someone who is able to oversee with grace. Jesus, you are that. You are that King. So I pray that we will be reminded to exalt you and not ourselves, because that is what is best for us, Jesus. So yeah, Jesus, I just pray that as we go about our week, we will be looking for opportunities to exalt you and lower ourselves. By exalting you, we serve others, Jesus. So I pray we'll look for opportunities, we'll be listening to your Spirit moving and your Spirit calling our attention to serve those around us, to love others well. Yeah, Jesus, you said if you love the least of these, then you have loved me. So I pray that as we walk down the street, as we drive around the city, we'll have our eyes open for the least of these. Yeah, Jesus, thank you that you are a good King who has set an example before us. In your name, amen. Thanks for worshiping with us, y'all. And just a way to actually like practice, you know, that prayer of exalting Jesus, of loving others well, looking for the least of these, is even just to give a quick phone call or give a quick text to someone you haven't talked to in a while or someone you're thinking about. You know, because the holidays can definitely be a stressful time for a lot of people, and it could definitely be a lonely time for a lot of people. So I would encourage you all to like get your phones before you switch over to the message, and call someone or give them a text. Just let them know that you're thinking about them and that they are loved, and that they aren't truly alone. So I encourage you all to do that. But that is the end of our worship service. Thanks again for joining us all, and I'll see you next week.